Welcome to the glass plate. In the example of today, we're going to look at laminar flow of a Newtonian liquid between two parallel plates. These plates are separated by a distance d and their size in the other direction, b, is very big. Flow is coming in, flowing in that direction. And we assume a steady state. So steady state, laminar flow, Newtonian. Okay, what I ultimately would like to know is what is the relation between delta P, the pressure drop over this tube, as a function of the mean velocity. Or rephrased, if I cast this in the standard form that we have, delta P equals 4F L over D hydraulic half rho V average squared. What is the Fanning friction factor in this case? Well, the nice thing, since it's laminar steady state and a relatively simple geometry, I can compute this. So we're going to do that. What I need to find is the velocity distribution, and I can anticipate that it will look something like this. The flow will be in the x direction, and it will have a variation in the y direction. So this is minus d over 2, and this is d over 2 itself. The axis runs between the plates. To find the distribution of the velocity, we know what to do is set up a steady state momentum balance, which boils down to a force balance for these type of geometries. And thus I have a force balance in the x direction. Sum of forces in the x direction is zero. And I need to find a control volume, and I'll take a small piece out of it and equate the sum of forces. So I'm going to repeat that here so that I can draw it a little bit bigger. It runs from x to x plus dx, and from y to y plus dy, somewhere in the fluid. There is a force from pressure on this side, and there is a force back from pressure on that side. Moreover, there is a potential shear stress, which is tau yx, x direction for velocity, y for the difference in velocity, and there is one here as well. These are the four forces, and I can set up my balance. So force balance is zero, and I just equate all the forces. First, pressure on the left side, x, times the area. Area is b times the height, this height, b times dy. Area times pressure. On the other side, pressing back, p, but at a little bit different position, same area. Okay, now these two. This one is a force, shear stress per unit area, and that is acting on the area b times dx, and it's sitting at position y. At the top, there is another force that I need to add, but it is sitting at y plus dy in the same area, but this gets a minus sign in front of it because of Newton 3. It is the larger coordinate liquid on the smaller one, and that is by definition not tau but minus tau. I can scratch out the b's, I can divide by dy and dx, and if I do that, I get a differential equation for tau d dy tau yx equals minus dp dx, which is, by the way, a constant due to symmetry in this direction. The pressure may drop, but it should drop everywhere at the same rate. So dp dx is a constant. This is a positive number. Dp dx is negative in the direction x that we choose. I can integrate this equation and thus find tau yx, which is a function of y, equals minus dp dx times the y coordinate plus an integration constant. Due to symmetry, there cannot be a force on the y is zero line. Or rephrased, there cannot be momentum exchange of y equals zero due to the symmetry. And thus, tau yx at zero is zero, giving me that this c1 equals zero. Now I need to solve this part. And I use that I have a Newtonian fluid, so the shear is the d dy of vx that I need to know, and that is minus dp dx over y, no constant. Integrate this one and find that vx equals 1 over 2 mu and a minus dp dx y squared plus another constant. The LF constant is found from a second boundary condition at y equals d over 2. The velocity v should be 0, and thus the total solution is vx equals 1 over 2 mu minus dp dx d squared over 4 minus y squared. All right, now I have v, that is the parabola that I draw here, but I need the average velocity. So I need to calculate the average velocity, that is integrating over the height, this velocity profile, and that is thus the integral of vx times b dy divided by the total area bd, and I integrate from minus d over 2 to d over 2. If I work out this integral, I can scratch out the b's and solve it. Let me just give you the answer. I find that this is 1 over mu times 1 over 12 d squared over, well, the view I already had, times dp dx. All right. So I have now the mean velocity, and I'll take off this x-coordinate to be consistent with this notation. I can turn this into relation for delta p, as minus dp dx equals delta p over L is thus, I can drop out the minus sign and scoop it up in the delta p definition, 12 mu over d squared times the average velocity, or delta p itself is 12 mu over d. I'll have to borrow a d to cast it in the form that I want, v. Delta p linear in v, but I need to write this in terms of v squared, thus I need to have a v under here as well. And I need to have that as a half rho v squared for delta p, so I need another 2 in front of this and a rho below. And you now see coming that this part, let me grab another color and see whether I can highlight that for you. This part has to do with my Fanning friction factor. Delta p, 4f, L over d, half rho v squared. But I'm not completely done. Need to be a little bit careful, because the question is, do I need d or the hydraulic diameter? And I need the hydraulic diameter. So we need to find what is the hydraulic diameter. dh is by definition 4 times the area through which the flow comes divided by the wetted perimeter. That is 4 times the area, that is b times d, divided by the wetted perimeter, that is a b here and at the bottom here another b, and there are no sides of d, and it's infinitely long, so it's a 2b. Scratch out the b and you find that it is 2 times d. So if you want to cast it in the right format as I defined it, I need to replace d by dh, and thus I need to write delta p equals, I had a 24 mu rho, instead of d I need to write the hydraulic diameter, so that takes up a 2. I write a 2D here. Now it's the hydraulic diameter, still times V in blue. And obviously I need to multiply by 2 because I've been dividing by 2. Then I need to write L over 2D, because I need also the hydraulic diameter there. And thus I have another 2. And then I have here half rho V squared. Right? Didn't do anything. Added 2s and took them out. And thus if I compute all the numbers, 24 times 2 times 2 is 96, divided by, this is the Reynolds number based on the hydraulic diameter, times L over the hydraulic diameter, times half rho V squared. And here is your 4F in terms of the hydraulic diameter. Another example of a laminar flow where you can compute exactly what goes on and cast it in one of the formulas. Check this out for yourself, see what I've done. Convince yourself that the mass sounds complicated, but in retrospect it's not, and that it's relatively straightforward copying from the same ideas that we used for Poiseuille flow through a cylindrical tube.